Objectives: Number 1. Explain the chain of infection. Number 2. Discuss the stages of infection. Number 3. Realize the importance of knowing the chain and stages of infection for prevention. Infection. An invasion of microorganisms into the body that are capable of producing a disease. Pathogen. It is an organism with the ability to cause disease. Bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoa, parasitic worms, rickettsiae. Number 2. Reservoir. It is a place within which microorganisms can thrive and reproduce. The most common reservoir is the human body. Number 3. Portal of exit. It provides a way for a microorganism to leave the reservoir through the nose, mouth, body feces. Number 4. Mode of transmission. It is the method by which the organism moves from one host to another. Direct contact, indirect contact, airborne, foodborne, waterborne, vectorborne. Number 5. Portal of entry. It is an opening allowing the microorganism enter the host. Body orifices, mucous membranes, breaks in the skin. Number 6. The susceptible host. It is a person who cannot resist a microorganism invading its body. Stages of infection. Recovery stage. Illness stage. Prodromal stage. Incubation stage. Incubation stage. It is when a person acquires the pathogen until the appearance of the first sign. Silent stage. Prodromal stage. It is when there are non-specific signs and symptoms appearing. Headache, runny nose, slight fever. Illness or clinical stage. It is the time when illness reaches its highest point of development. Severe aches, vomiting, high fever, sore throat, sinus congestion. Recovery or convalescence stage. This is the time when recovery seems complete although the disease is still communicable. Pathogen has mostly eliminated. Number 1. These are diseases which are transferred from one person to another. Number 2. What is the disease-causing microorganism that attack the body and infect cells? Number 3. This is the interval between entrance of pathogen into the body to the appearance of first symptoms. Number 4. It is the route of escape of the pathogen from the reservoir. Number 5. The stage of infection wherein the illness reaches its highest point of development. Arrange the following processes in chronological order. Write letters A to E on the space provided before each number. A is first step, B second step, so on. Number 6. Convalescence stage is recovery stage. Number 7. Illness stage is when specific severe signs and symptoms appear. Number 8. Incubation stage is when a person acquires the pathogen. Number 9. Prodromal stage is when there are non-specific signs and symptoms appearing. Number 10. Decline stage, time when the signs and symptoms of the sick person slowly go down. The chain of infection starts when a pathogen lives in. Number 11. Passed through a direct or indirect mode of transmission. Number 12. Reservoir, which can be a living or non-living object. when the pathogen. Number 13. Susceptible host if one who has a low immunity resistance is the next victim. Number 14. Leaves the reservoir through a portal of exit, the pathogen is. Number 15. The organism enters then the body through a portal of entry and the Number 1. These are diseases which are transferred from one person to another. The correct answer is communicable diseases or infectious diseases. Number 2. What is the disease-causing microorganism that attack the body and infect cells? The correct answer is pathogen, causative agent. Number 3. This is the interval between entrance of pathogen into the body to the appearance of first symptoms. The correct answer is incubation stage. Number 4. It is the route of escape of the pathogen from the reservoir. The correct answer is portal of exit. Number 5. The stage of infection wherein the illness reaches its highest point of development. The correct answer is illness stage or clinical stage. Number 1. Now that you have understood the stages of infection, choose the stage where you think is the best stage to cut from the flow of infection and explain why you chose that stage. Write your answer in a one whole sheet of paper. Number 2. Research also on the internet the 6 kinds of pathogens and list 3 examples of diseases that are caused by those pathogens.